Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over how to make an organizational chart in Excel using SmartArt. Once we've made it, we'll create links from some of the titles to their team bio. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. In this tab, I've already created a list of the positions in two departments in an organization. We'll use this to create the org chart. So I'm going to highlight and then right-click. So I can copy all of the titles, and then in a blank spreadsheet, go to the Insert tab, and in the Illustration section, select SmartArt Graphics. And here we have different categories of SmartArt Graphics to choose from. I'm going to click on Hierarchy, and this brings up different styles of charts we can select from, including some that can accommodate for pictures. I just want to talk about this one for a quick second, the name and title organizational chart. My own preference, I like to stay away from using this one because you can't fill in the smaller boxes right from the text pane, which is what we're going to be doing in this example. So you have to go into each one of the little boxes and type the information manually. And I think that can be a bit more burdensome than some of the other options. So for this example, we're going to select this first organization chart and click OK. From here in the text pane, I'm just selecting everything and then pasting in the titles that we copied a moment ago. Okay, so first thing I want to do is actually drag the org chart over and make it bigger so we can see what's happening. Let's expand this a little bit more. So when we pasted these in, all the positions are at the same level. And when I created the list of titles that we pasted here into our text pane, I tried to make it so that it was already organized by department and in hierarchical order. This makes it easier to use tabs to reformat how who reports to whom is displayed. So now we can use tabs in our text pane to help illustrate which position reports into which other position. So for example, the executive assistant to the president reports into the president, so we'll tab over once. The vice president of marketing also reports to the president, so we'll tab over one more time. The executive assistant to the vice president of marketing will, of course, report into the vice president of marketing, so we'll tab over twice, and you see how this has changed our org chart here to the right. The director of marketing reports to the vice president of marketing as well. And there's two senior marketing managers, so we can highlight both of them. And both of those will report into the director of marketing. The marketing managers, we can highlight all of those and tab those over together to report under the senior marketing manager. And then the admin assistant in marketing, we'll tab over one more time and they report into the marketing managers. The vice president of HR also reports into the president, so tab over once and you see that now a line beneath the president. The executive assistant to the VP of HR and the director of HR both report to the vice president of HR, so tab over one more time underneath the vice president. And same thing with the senior HR managers, they report into the director of HR. And we can highlight all of the HR managers. Those will report there, and the admin assistant in HR will report to the HR managers. Let's hide this, move this over so we can see it all together. So it's likely that over time there will be changes to the positions and some will need to be moved, deleted, or new ones added, and we can do that right from the text pane. So we'll open that and we'll expand it so we can see it. So let's say, for example, we have a third senior HR manager. We can just come to the second senior HR manager on our list and click enter and then just type in that new position. And let's say we want to move the admin assistant in HR to report to a different manager. So I've highlighted this and used the cut feature. And then now we'll move that role underneath the second HR manager, paste it, and then tab over so that it now changes to reporting into this individual. Let's close this. So you may have noticed your SmartArt tools options up here. So we can use this to style and format how our organizational chart will look. So for example, we can change this so that it's right to left instead of left to right. You can decide to switch to a different layout up here, which we're not going to be doing. We can change the colors, which I want to change to this color. and then a different style. Let's go with this one. I'm actually going to just bold them so that they look a little bit bigger. And then in format here, you can affect the shapes that you're using, the fills, what the text looks like, and some of the sizing. I'm also going to come up here to the View tab and get rid of the grid lines so that it looks a bit cleaner. So a couple of things to consider with using SmartArt for org charts is, one, you can't automatically add dotted line reports. To do that, you would have to insert your own line, and you can do that from Shapes, select your line, and let's say you want the senior HR manager to have a dotted line report to the vice president of HR. You would have to do that manually and format it. Could right click on it to get to the format shape, and then here, just making sure that you're in the line section, scroll to your dash type and select a dotted line. Let's close this. You know, just keep in mind that if the positions move around, so for example, if we were in design and we went right to left, we'd have to make sure to manually move this line. Undo that. So you also want to avoid dragging and moving the shapes. So while this is an option to do, let's say you want to change the layout of these and you want them to be left hanging. Notice how all of the shapes move so that they're still aligned together, except for the shape that we just dragged manually and the dotted line that we added manually. So worst case scenario, let's say you've saved and closed this document and opened it another time, you can always reset your graphics, but this also gets rid of any other formatting that you may have done. So let's undo these. Now that we've organized our org chart the way we want, we can add links to the bios of some of the senior associates. I've already created bios on this tab, and to make it easier to link, have also created named ranges for each. So coming back to our org chart, simply select the shape that you want to add a link to, right click on it and select link. If you want to link it to a web page or a different file, you can select that here. But for this example, we're going to select place in this document, and you see our defined names already listed here. So since this is the precedent, I'm going to click on precedent bio and click OK. Now, when you click on precedent, you automatically jump to their bio. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to create an organizational chart in Microsoft Excel using SmartArt. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.